you're all well today. I'm really, really wanting to do a full glam look with a strong smoky eye, but not using like my usual warm brown tones. I just feel like doing green. I'm not sure why. That's why I'm wearing green. I just want to go all out with the green. First things first, you may already know this if you follow me on Instagram, but I got my brows tattooed on, which sounds very scary, but actually it's not scary at all. I have been wanting to do this for, ask anyone that's close to me. I've been talking about it for a long time, but I was just really scared to do it. I was really scared to jump in, and obviously it's semi-permanent, so it's a bit of a commitment, especially if you don't like the result. But I love the result. It's really, really natural. They're 5 days in, so I have to be really careful with makeup, I think. You can check out the before and afters and commonly asked questions over on my Instagram, @LozCurtis. I got sent these shadow shields. I'd heard about them. They kind of just look like panty liners cut into like a moon shape, to be blatantly honest. But you can use them to get a clean, crisp line. You know what? I really like this idea because when it comes to winged eyeliner, I always stuff up the wing. It's either too far down or it's too far up, but it's meant to just follow the line of your lower lash line. But for some reason, I'm unable to do that. I don't know why, I just can't do it. I can sometimes, but it's like a luck of the draw type thing. Whereas this follows my natural lash line. So if I created liner based off that, it would be like a really nice line. Boom, I like this. I'm just going to use my shape tape in the shade Fair Natural. Just using this big brush from Laura Mercier, the Camouflage Powder Brush. I'm not sure why this would be a powder brush, but that's fine. I'm not gonna blend all the way up to my brow. I'm just gonna grab some translucent powder and set that area down. Can't wait to see Reese's reaction when he comes home and I've got his little discs on my face. For my transition color, I'm going to use the Tartlet Toasted palette, which is their new one. I'm gonna start off by grabbing this one here, which is called Cashmere, and then I will go in with Warmth. So just back and forth. So now I'm going in with the next shade, which is called Warmth. It's beautiful. Blend out super easily. I'm actually surprised I'm so upbeat today. Yesterday I was like a gloomy mess. I got my period at the same time as getting sick, so I ordered a big brownie off Uber Eats and just watched Jenna Marbles on YouTube while I ate my brownie. Ow, I just poked my eyeball. Sorry, I was also using the Morphe M533 brush for that, and then I'm using the Morphe M513 brush, which is just a tad smaller, and I'm using Warmth still. Okay, next I'm going to use Cozy. This one here. It's much more of a red, so hopefully that's going to... Yeah, there we go. This is what I always do when I'm working with smoky eyes. I always like to build up my transition, because then when you place the black on your lid, it just blends straight in and you avoid that black eye look. A lot of people avoid smoky eyes because they think that they're really scary, because when you apply the black, it's just like, oh. And black is so hard to blend out, but this technique has never failed me. Next, I'm going to use the Makeup Store Micro Shadow in Pollution. This is just a matte black. And I'm going to use it on the same brush, the Morphe M513. And then start working that into the crease. I'm going to use a cream product on the lids. This is just building up into the crease, because it is a lot harder to blend creams out into the crease, especially when powder's already there. So, clay paint liner, eyeliner in black. I'm gonna try this one. This is in like a squeezy bottle, and hopefully it'll be easier to work with on the lid. That one was blocked, I think, so I just grabbed a smaller one. Same thing, but it's a smaller version, and it comes out like that. I'm just going to use that with the Sigma Cream Color E58 brush. Oh yeah, see, this is actually what I wanted. Oh, this would be an amazing eyeliner, which it actually is. I need to start using this. Oh my god, it blends so easily. Then I'm going to take the Real Techniques Base Shadow Brush. A bit more of that, just a little bit more of that onto the brush, and then blend that into Ooh, this is gonna be hard to blend. Maybe I shouldn't have used this one. I'm just gonna try and blend that into the crease a little bit, which is proving to be difficult. So I'm gonna have to go back in with this clover brush and the Makeup Store eyeshadow to blend that out. Yeah, that's better. So basically I just turned my makeup room upside down trying to find the perfect green eyeshadow. And funnily enough, it is really quite difficult. Not many brands make like a true forest green without it having some kind of bluish undertones or being more blue than green. But I found one. Makeup Geek Foiled Eyeshadow in Epic. I'm going to use the Sigma Firm Shader E57 brush. Yeah. If you want to really pack this on, then by all means go ahead and use your finger, but I'd rather add slowly in this instance because I don't want to ruin the look. Gotta be careful with how that separates in the crease. As you can see, there's a distinct line. I'm just gonna apply this eyeshadow and then I'll fix that after. Now I'm going to go in with my finger and apply that straight to the lid just to intensify the color, because as always, a brush just doesn't do a good of a job, but at least I've got that foundation down and it's kind of blended out already a little bit, so it'll be easier when I go in with my finger. I'm purposely leaving the outer portion of my eye just plain black because I don't want it to be fully green all over my eyelid. I'm going to try, I don't know if it's gonna backfire, hopefully not, Urban Decay eyeshadow in Sideline. It is one of these duochrome ones. I just wanted to kind of make the inner corner pop. Ooh, yes, that's doing what I wanted to do. For eyeliner, I'm going to use this brush here. It's just by Tarte. Oops, I'm not sure what it's called, but it looks like that. And that same amazing new favorite gel liner. Ooh, it's so easy to apply. So I'm hoping that those wings are even, but I really can't say for sure. Ooh, the moment is here, the moment of truth. Ooh, geez. Ooh. Okay, too sticky. Too sticky. You would not want to use these most days because you'll get wrinkles underneath your eyes. Whoa. Crisp. But I would like to start with the Fenty Pro Filter Instant Retouch Primer. I don't have the foundation, but it's coming to me. So I will use that in a different video, which is the like number one thing I'm excited about out of her whole range is the foundation. I love the packaging. I love this soft matte finish. It's so nice. I'm just gonna use this Sigma 3D HD Max Kabuki brush to blend this out. Probably not the right brush to use, but it's fine. I don't really know how to assess primers. They kind of just, I don't know. Feels fine, but doesn't feel out of this world or anything. Has made my skin feel smooth though. For foundation, I'm going to mix two of these Makeup Store Sculpt Excellence foundations. This one is in the shade Corn and this one is in the shade Cinnamon. Just using my favorite Morphe G7 brush. Okay, I'm thinking this color is much too dark. Got to keep in mind that I've got fake tan on my face as well, and that's why it's going darker than it normally would. So now I'm just taking that Laura Mercier brush we used at the very start to carefully work my way around my eyes. I'm going to try one of these Fenty Beauty matchsticks. This one is in the shade Linen. I'm just gonna try it on my chin first. So it is kind of just like a stick foundation. I'm just going in and applying some more of my foundation because it looked weird on my chin. Try a bit in between my brows. Probably the wrong shade to use underneath. I just wanted to have that chiseled, kind of contoured look. Yeah. Nope. It's nice once I add foundation to it and really blend it out. But when it's on its own, it just looks like it's a bit too much. To highlight underneath my eyes, I'm going to use the ColourPop No Filter Concealer in the shade Fair 5. I like to use this with my Beauty Blender because it just absorbs the concealer as it's applied. So it doesn't become too full coverage and cakey. Just using my MAC Mineralized Skin Finish to set this in place. I'm going to use the Face of Australia Loose Translucent Setting Powder for my face. To contour, I'm going to use the Too Faced Milk Chocolate Soleil Light Medium Matte Bronzer. Looks like this, with the Sigma Soft Angled Contour Brush. For blush, I'm going to use this Tarte Amazonian Blush Bazaar Clay Blush Palette. I'm going to use Angelic, this shade here, with my Ray Morris Kabuki brush. Whoa. For my highlight, I'm going to use the Fenty Beauty Kilowatt Freestyle Highlighter Duo, and I'm worried it's going to be really, really light, but I still really want to try it. So I'm going to try this one on the left first. I feel like it might be a little bit less intense. Oh, that's nice. I do want to try this other one here. It's just so crazy that I'm scared. Oh, I don't know. I'll just try a little bit. It doesn't really do too much. It just makes it a bit more silvery, I think. Oh, I was meant to use the brush. Oh well, next time. Now I have been given the go ahead to be able to fill in my brows. I'm just going to use a powder and just lightly define them. I'm not going to go overboard. Seeing how good they look filled in as well just makes me wish I had done this whole process earlier. I'm gonna grab the eyeshadow in Pollution, a black one, with the Sigma Short Shader E10 brush, and I'm going to just push that into my lower lash line. I'm going to grab that green shade again. Mia's barking at nothing. I'm going to grab the Makeup Store Eye Pencil in Darkest Shadow. And tight line and line my waterline. Just gonna grab a smaller brush. This is the Makeup Geek pencil brush. And I think I need to blend that further down my lash line because it looks a little bit weird how it just ends. Next, I'm just going to apply some mascara. This is the Tarte Light Camera Lashes in the special packaging. I love applying this when I'm wearing falsies because it makes my lashes so thick underneath and black and super dramatic. For my lashes, I'm going to use the Pure Pro Eyelashes in Jet Setter. I want to try this product here from Fenty Beauty. It is the Fenty Glow Gloss Bomb. I don't think I would just wear this, but I've seen everyone wearing it and it just seems like a really nice universal shade. So, see what it's like. Ooh, that is a nice color. That's a really, really nice color. It's kind of like a My Lips, but better shade. I'm actually gonna grab a bit more of this Urban Decay Sideline Shadow and apply that just in the inner corner to highlight. For lips, I'm going to try the Tarte Pink Lemonade Color Splash Lipstick. I'm These are so comfortable to wear. I'm actually going to stick with the shade because it matches my cheeks. It matches that transition color quite nicely. It's kind of like a peachy pinky nude. I'm thinking I'm gonna take the earrings out. I just don't think they suit the look. I hardly ever wear smoky eyes that are this dark, but when I do, sometimes you just want something a little bit more interesting than just a plain black. And this is a really nice, subtle way of bringing color into the look, especially for Halloween coming up. If you did want to be something that involves, like, I don't know, a witch or something, it may be perfect for it. Of course, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up or like it. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you all so much for watching. I love you guys, and I hope to see you all in my next video. Bye, everyone.